The Buffalo Bills get a B minus from me. I know that everyone's excited that Josh Allen is coming to Buffalo, and he could be the potential franchise quarterback, but people forget that JP Lossman was a below 60% passer, and I think the second to last quarterback taken in the first round by Buffalo. I mean, Buffalo for some reason likes to take a bunch of inaccurate big arm throwers in the first round. They did it with EJ Manuel in 2013, and they did it with Lossman in 2004. And when Allen already played with no team in Wyoming, and he had a lot of flaws when he played also, I don't think that that can help a team like Buffalo when they could lack a lot of talent. The wide receiver core is not impressive in my opinion, even if Kelvin Benjamin is on that team. Benjamin is not the receiver that he was as a rookie. He doesn't have the best conditioning habits in comparison to other players who've played for the Bills, like Marquise Goodwin. I mean, Goodwin has been able to compete, if not be in Olympic trials for USA Track and Field. But it's not, I mean, I think that you have to worry. And the offensive line, like, so many subtractions, especially with the losses of Cordy Glenn, Eric Wood, Chandrell Henderson, although not a great player, just to be kind, and potentially Richie Incognito because of how he wanted to retire and then get released by the Bills, and the fact that he's already a pretty unstable person, based off of his history and how he's acted, especially when he was not employed. If you look at what happened between his time with the Dolphins and with the Bills in his second go around, you will see what a crazy person he can be. But as far as the other players are concerned, Tremaine Edmonds, great athlete, whose tape is somewhat questionable. His tape doesn't really match up to his athleticism and his physical attributes. Edmonds is somebody who is not this, like, bad tape one combine wonder kind of player. I have to just emphasize that. He's a guy whose athleticism you could find on tape, but he doesn't look like a polished tackler or a polished pass rusher of any like a lot of other more po like a lot of more accomplished players. He's not like Leighton Van Der Esch, and I think that Edmonds is somebody who could have a hard time, adjusting in the league when he first gets in, but maybe with McDermott, he could find success considering McDermott's track record with players such as Luke Kuechly, Thomas Davis, and Shaq Thompson. So I think that it's easier to be more optimistic about Edmonds than it is to be about Allen. Harrison Phillips could be the successor to Kyle Phillips one day because I don't know. Kyle Williams, forgive me, the one-time third-round pick out of LSU. Like Williams, he is a third-round pick at a major school, and he had a lot of attractive features as an interior lineman, but he played in a 3-4 at Stanford, so the transition will be a little bit more difficult as he tries to play the 3 technique over at Buffalo. But I think that his future, it's worth looking at either next year or maybe 2 or 3 years down the line. Potentially a good draft. The picks have their own flaws to say the least, except it's difficult to get excited about this draft considering that Buffalo's current roster construction and 2018 outlook looks pretty bleak to say the least.